वी वेयर आर डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग द थियोडोलाइट.
ओके सो वी विल इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी वर डिस्कसिंग ऑन द डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ थियोडोलाइट दैट इज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज सेंटरिंग राइट व्हाट इज सेंटरिंग बाय द वे व्हाट इज सेंटरिंग कैन एनीबॉडी टेल मी एंड दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू सेट योर थियोडोलाइट इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डू एनी मिस्टेक हियर देन यू आर देर विल बी सम वेरिएशंस इन योर रीडिंग Whenever you are going to take the readings, there will be the mistakes will be there in your reading if you don't do centering leveling properly or elimination of parallax. If you don't do it properly, there will be the mistakes. So, can anybody tell me what is centering by see, looking at the diagram? By looking at the diagram, can anybody tell me what is centering? Yes.
Setting out the instrumentation over the station.
Over the
Station.
Yes. What is centering?
Station point.
Setting the vertical axis exactly over the station point. This is what we call it as a centering. See, here I think you can able to see this vertical axis. Yes. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay. So what
Yes,
we are going to do here is we are going to set this vertical axis. Now suppose this is your station point. Consider this as a station point. What we are going to do here is we are setting this vertical axis exactly over the station point, right? So that is nothing but we call it as a centering. So we will read the definition once again, right? We will read the definition once again. Centering means setting the theodolite exactly over the instrument station so that the vertical axis lies immediately above the station mark. It can be done by means of plumb bob suspended by a small hook attached to the vertical axis. Now, how we are going to check this centering? We are going to check this by attaching a plumb bob. I think you know how the plumb bob is. Have you seen the plumb bob? Have you seen the plumb
Yes,
bob?
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, I will show you the plumb
Yes,
bob.
sir.
Okay, then good. If you have seen, then I won't show it. Okay, so I hope that the things will be clear to you by this particular diagram. Okay, so now here what we are going to do, we are going to check whether the vertical axis is going to exactly meet the station point by tying an plumb bob to this. Now we will see what are the other points because these definitions will become very important to you then all these points will become very important. Now what is transiting? Transiting is also known as plunging or reversing. Okay, yesterday someone has told whether transiting, right? Traversing and transiting. So transiting is also known as the plunging or reversing, right? It is the process of turning the telescope about its horizontal axis through the 180 degrees in a vertical plane. Transiting is nothing but changing the face of the telescope, right? If here the eyepiece is there, if I want to bring it over here, right? If the eyepiece is over here, if I want to bring it over here, through which axis I will move it? Through horizontal, I will move it. Axis, I will move it. In a vertical plane, I will be moving it. So that is nothing but the transiting. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Again, I am doing some repetition. Right? Swinging is nothing but, what is swinging? Can anybody tell me? What is swinging? Yes, what is swinging? These things are very important. What is swinging? Yes?
Turning the telescope in vertical axis in an horizontal plane.
That means swinging means, right? I'll repeat it once again. Turning the telescope in an which axis? Through vertical axis in an horizontal plane. That means if you want to measure the angle present between the two points on the ground, if you want to measure the angle, then you are going to use the word called as a swinging. Okay. If you want to measure the two angle which are present angle between the two points which are present on the ground. If you want to measure it, right, you are going to swing the telescope in a vertical axis on a horizontal plane. Okay, so this is what your swinging is. Face left, you know that if the vertical axis is towards the face, left face of the observer is towards the left side of the observer, then we call it as a face left. Face right, if the vertical circle, if it is present towards the right side of the observer, we call it as a face right. Changing the face is nothing but from the left to right, we are going to change it, right? And the line of culmination is nothing but the line of sight, right? Here, from here, you are going to look, right, through the eyepiece towards the object, right? And if both this line and this line, if it is going to get culminated with each other, then we call it as a line of culmination. It is an imaginary line joining the intersection of the crosshair of the diaphragm to the optical center of the object glass and its continuation. That is nothing but your line of culmination. Now, axis of the telescope. Axis of telescope, it is also known as the imaginary line joining the optical center of the object glass to the center of the eyepiece. So this center and this center, if it is going to match with each other, then we call it as an axis of the telescope. Okay, then the axis of the level 2B is nothing but it is a straight line tangential to the longitudinal curve of the level 2 at the center of the bubble. Yesterday I have shown you the bubble 2, right? If it is exactly at the center, right, then that particular thing we call it as an the axis of the bubble 2. Now, what is vertical axis? Vertical axis is, you already know it, vertical axis is helpful for supporting which circle, horizontal circle or horizontal circle, horizontal plate or a vertical plate? Vertical axis supports
horizontal
what?
Plate.
Yes. Vertical horizontal axis supports what?
Vertical plate.
Vertical plate or the vertical scale. Okay. I hope, and we also call this horizontal axis as a trunnion axis, where the telescope is going to be mounted. Okay. So I'll show it once again. Why I'm repeating these things is because if you understand these things, then it is going to become very, very easy. See, horizontal axis, right? On this horizontal axis, vertical plate is being mounted. On this vertical axis, the horizontal plate is being mounted. So this is horizontal axis, this is vertical axis. I hope the things are clear to you. Okay, horizontal axis you already know. Now, in today's class, we are going to discuss regarding the very, very important aspect of theodolite, that is the temporary adjustment of theodolite. See, when you are going to set the instrument on a ground, right, when you are going to set the instrument on a ground, right, this temporary adjustment will become very, very important. Okay, this temporary adjustment will become very, very important. Okay, just I will tell you, I will explain how it is going to be important. See, all these are you are having here a total station. I will show you the theodolite. Okay, and whether it is a theodolite or whether it is a total station, the centering is going to be very, very important aspect. Why is, right, all these are total station. I am able to see it over here. Anyhow, whether it is a theodolite or whether it is your total station, the centering will become very, very important, right? Why is? This image is clear to you all? Or else I will save it and then I'll show you. Now, what is centering? Right? What is centering? Now, there are three very, very important aspects are there in your, temporary adjustment of theodolites. Right? There are very, very important aspects in theodolites. First is centering. Now, what is this centering is? What do you mean by centering? Now, centering is nothing but setting the vertical axis exactly over the station point. Now, this is the red color ones, whatever you are going to see, that is your station point, right? From here, you are going to center the instrument. Now, this is your vertical axis, right? This is your vertical axis, and this is your horizontal axis. Now, the what you are going to do in a centering is, you are making this center, your vertical line, exactly over this station point, right? If it is going to not match with the vertical axis of the theodolite, if it is not matching with the, just a minute, if it is not going to match with the center of your station, right, somewhere if it is going to be wrongly matched, and here it is now completely plain, right? But there might be some ground where you are going to find out too much amount of undulation, and there you are going to, by mistakenly, you are going to set the different point where you are going to have some undulation. There you are going to set, then, right, your height of the instrument is going to change. I think you know what is the HI, right? Suppose now this is your theodolite instrument you are going to set over here, right? And suppose you have set out on an undulated ground. Okay. Now, here, exactly your vertical axis lies. Right. Now, instead of you marking it here, right, somewhere if you mark your station point, it has station center point here, where your vertical axis is going to match exactly over here. Now, your height of the instrument is going to change. Your HI is going to change. So, this particular centering is going to be very, very important. Normally in a plain ground, it doesn't changes a lot, right? But if there are too much amount of undulations, as you can see in this particular picture, if it is going to have the too much amount of undulation, then it is going to create a problem, because HI is going to be required in your calculation. So if you go wrong in having the centering, then you are going to do the mistakes in your calculation. So whenever you are going to do the centering, the vertical axis should exactly meet with the station point when both the station point and the vertical axis, if they are exactly coinciding with each other, right? If they are exactly coinciding with each other, then only we can say that it is properly centered. Along with this centering, we also should see the level tube. Okay, your optical plummet, the vertical axis is exactly meeting through the optical plummet, then only you can say that your theodolite is actually, it has been centered. Is it clear to you all?
Yes, sir.
The voice is not strong. I think there are some doubts. Do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Sahil is having any doubt? Or
no, sir.
Someone has told there is some doubt. Manoj, do you have any doubt? Manoj?
No, sir.
No, no, right? Sir. Can I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Okay.
Then we were discussing regarding your temporary adjustment. So centering is over. Okay. Now the other thing what we are going to have is leveling. Second important, see, in the temporary adjustment, the first important point is centering. The vertical axis of the theodolite should exactly meet with the station point. It should meet with the center of the station, or it should meet with the center point. How we are going to check it? Either we are going to check it with the plumb bob or optical plummet. So this is what the centering is. Now the leveling, right? Yesterday I have shown you the level tube, right? Yesterday I have shown you the level tube, right? You need to remember this level tube. Okay, yesterday I was showing some level tube opening. Exactly over here, this is what the level tube is. Okay, now this is your level tube. Okay, I have shown you, I have told that your this leveling is going to be very, very important aspect when you are going to have when you are going to have the surveying, right? If you don't level it properly, right? Here there are two screws are there. Here actually in this picture there are two screws, but actual speaking there will be the three. In this particular picture you can only see the two screws, right? This we call it as the screws. Okay, this is going to help in the level, maintaining the level of the instrument. You can see that, right? If we you these from these two level, right, from these leveling screws, right, we can level the instrument. If suppose if it is up, so one side is upside, one side is downside, then we are going to lose the balance of the instrument. When we are going to lose the balance of the instrument, then there are the crosshairs which are present, right? It is going to move up and down. That means, right, suppose this is your instrument, right? This is your instrument. This is particularly your telescope is. Now there is some assembly over here, right? Now with this particular screws you are going to maintain the, this is suppose this is your screws. If you are maintaining, right, one is towards upside and one is towards downside, right, what will happen due to this setting, what will happen, your line of collimation will be somewhat like this. One side is upside, one side is towards downside, right? Your line of collimation will be like this. So what will happen to your reading? Whatever the reading you are going to take, it will not be correctly measured. See, this leveling screws are going to maintain the balance of this particular theodolite. So whenever you are going to do the leveling should be done accurately so that this tri-batch should be perfectly horizontal. I think you can look towards this tri-batch, right? I think it is visible to you all. Tri-batch is visible in that. Yes, tri-batch. I am focusing on this tri-batch. Yes, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, if...
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. Just a minute. Somewhere that it has went. Just a second. Yes. Okay. So if you move it, right, if the screw is not exactly, if it is not properly leveled, then this tri-batch will lose its level. Say it will become tilted. It will become tilted means your line of sight will also become tilted. Due to this, your line of sight is become tilted, your readings you are going to go wrong. Whatever the readings you are going to take, it is not going to be proper reading. Suppose if you want to read over here, but your telescope will be focused like this. Can you take the readings properly? No. So you may go wrong if you are going to do wrong leveling. Now, how we should do the leveling? I will tell you. How we should do the leveling. We will be having three screws in order to level the instrument. As I have told, we will be having the three screws, right? It will be perfectly in a triangular shape, right? It will be perfectly in a triangular shape. We will be having the three screws, right? So these two screws, right, with exactly horizontal to each other, and it is this particular screw C, it is going to be opposite side of this. Now, when you are going to see or when you are going to level the instrument, see, this is your screw A and screw B. Now, when you should rotate it, right, you should rotate it inside towards each other. Simultaneously, you should, both the screws should be either rotated inside or it should be rotated outside. Both, it should not happen that you are moving this towards outside and you are going to move towards this inside. No. Either it should be in a clockwise, both the screws should be moved in a clockwise direction or in an anti-clockwise direction. Now, if you are going to keep your telescope along with this particular thing, your telescope, right? Telescope which is there in this particular diagram, right? Telescope which is there in this particular diagram, it should be also, right? If you are going to move, right? These are the two screws, right? From which you are going to maintain the level of the instrument, right? What you are going to do, you should move both together, either inside or towards the outside when you are going to level it, right? Now, along with these, but now the both the screws are in one direction. Now, along with this screws, you are also going to keep the telescope in that, but in the direction of screw itself, right? Here, along with these two screws, you are going to keep the telescope in this direction itself. Now, suppose, there are two screws. Here, there are two screws. Now, your telescope, right, it should be in this direction only, right? When you are going to level it, it should be in this direction only. Now, simultaneously, what you should do, you should rotate this either inside, do both the screws either inside and outside. And here, as I have told, there will be the leveling tube will be there. So here, your bubble, when you are going to do the leveling, your bubble should come exactly at the center. Your bubble, right, bubble of the level tube should come exactly over center. Now, suppose if your bubble is not at center, suppose if it is somewhere, it is coming, going to come over here. Suppose somewhere, if it is going to come over here, right? That means, suppose this is your, if it is coming over here, this is your bubble center. If it is coming, going to come over here, then it represents that it is not leveled properly. Now, in order to level it properly, what you should do, this bubble should be exactly at the center. Now, what I have told, I'll repeat it once again. This is your screw A, this is your screw B, right? When you are going to maintain the level of the you want to level the instrument, right, both the screws you should either move it in in one direction only, right? You should move either inwards or with the outward. Both the screws should be simultaneously moved either inwards or outward. This is, now I am moving this towards the inward side, right? Either you can move it towards the inwards or simultaneously you should move it towards the outwards. Okay, simultaneously you should move towards this outer side. Now, again, while doing this, your telescope should be in the direction of, should be in the direction of the screws. Now, once if the bubble is coming at the center, now you can say that the level your instrument is leveled from one side. Still the complete leveling is not over. Okay. Now, the leveling with these two screws is get over. Now we are having one more screw, right? We are going to have one more screw here. Now you have leveled with this particular screw, right? You have leveled the instrument with this particular screw, with having the telescope in this particular direction, you have leveled it. Now, in the other side, the other way how you are going to do the leveling is, now this horizontal level, horizontal, by keeping the telescope horizontal to the
this particular two screws is over. Now you should, right? You should bring the telescope towards the point C. That means
your telescope will be now in this particular position. Okay, I'll just show it. Now you are going to set the instrument according to the screw C, right? Now here your telescope will be, it should be like this. You should keep it like this, right? Here will be your eyepiece, and now you should rotate the screw C, right? Either in a clockwise direction or in an anti-clockwise direction, and you should see that the bubble tube should be at the center. The bubble tube or your bubble, right, should be at the center. It should be, it should come at the center. If it is coming somewhere here or if somewhere here, then you should rotate the screws accordingly, and you can set, you can make it at center. Now here, when your instrument is said to be completely leveled, is when you are both the bubble tube, like by keeping this and by keeping horizontal to the screws A and B, by keeping perpendicular to the screws A and B, if the bubble is coming exactly at the center, here also it should be center, right? Here also it should be center. Then only you can say that your instrument is properly leveled. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Completely clear? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. No, sir. Okay. Right. Good. So you can have this particular leveling when you are going to deal with the, exactly with the instrument. Now the things might be there. There might be some doubts might be there to you. You can ask to me, right, in your free time, right? But you can, you will learn this leveling when you are going to exactly deal with the instrument, right? In your field, you are going to completely know how to do the leveling. How to do the leveling. Just in, I will repeat it, how to do the leveling, right? First, these are screws A and B, right? You are going to keep the telescope in the direction of, that is horizontal to A and B. Either you are going to move towards these A and B screws, either inward or together, together I am saying, either inward A and B or towards the outward, right? And the telescope, right, when you are going to do like this, right, your bubble should be, should come exactly over the center. If it is going to move somewhere here or somewhere here, right, it is not centered. When the bubble is going to come exactly over the center, then only you can say it is completely centered. Then you are going to make the telescope, right, perpendicular to A and B, or in the direction of C, you are going to make it. And then again, you will be turning this without touching the screws A and B. You should not touch the screws A and B afterwards. And then you will only turn the screw C. Then you are making it either in a clockwise direction or in an anti-clockwise direction, and you will try to make it center. Now, after doing this, if you rotate the telescope, right, you are, you should, if you rotate the telescope, the bubble tube should be at the center. Right, the bubble tube should be at the center. Okay, so I hope this is understood. Yes, I hope this is understood.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
You can see the bubble tube over here. Yes, right, you can see the bubble tube over here. If you, after leveling the instrument, even if you rotate through 360 degree angle also, right, it will be at a center if it is properly leveled. If you don't level the instrument properly, right, definitely you are going to do the mistakes, or you are, whatever the readings you are going to take it, it, there will be some error will be there in that particular reading if your instrument is not properly centered. Okay, I hope the things are clear to you. Now, next thing what I wanted to tell is, right, regarding the elimination of parallax. The third adjustment in your survey, in your temporary adjustment, is we are going to have the focusing. Now, focusing, how we can do with the instrument is, right, how we can elimination, we call it as an focusing or elimination of parallax, right? We call it as an elimination of parallax or we call it as an focusing. How we can do is, elimination of parallax means, see, here as we are going to have the lenses, right? Here we are going to use the lens in your instrument. Both eyepiece is there and the objective is there. Objective is there, right? Lens is there here. Here, you can see that there is a lens over here towards the eyepiece and the object. There will be the glasses, right? There, both the ends, we are going to have the glass. And here, we are going to have the crosshair, right? If I look through this particular eyepiece and if my crosshairs are not able to visible clearly, then, right, then or the object which is present far ahead, if it is not going to look properly and if the crosshairs are not visible, then we should adjust the lenses so that the your crosshairs should be visible completely and the object should be completely visible. If we don't see the crosshair, then the reading, whatever we are going to take, it won't be accurate, and the reading which are present on our crosstalk, it is not going to be visible if you are not going to do the adjustments on your eyepiece as well as the objective lens. So how we can do it is, right, we can eliminate the parallax, right? Elimination of parallax. We'll see what is parallax first. Parallax is a condition in which the image is formed will not lie on the plane of those crosshairs. That means that can be eliminated by focusing the eyepiece. Whatever the object is there in front of you or in front of the instrument, right, it is not going to be visible by the crosshairs, or the crosshairs will not be visible. So that is nothing but we can call it as a parallax, right? So we need to eliminate that. The parallax we should eliminate in order to have the proper readings. Now, how we can eliminate that parallax? For focusing the eyepiece, right, what we should do is, we should hold the white paper in front of objective and move eyepiece, right, in or out. We should move this eyepiece in and out, right, in order to see the parallax or the, in order to see the crosshairs. What we should do is, we should adjust this eyepiece, right, so that those crosshairs should be visible to us. Okay, for focusing the eyepiece, hold the white paper here in front of your objective lens. We should hold the white paper here, right, in front of the object lens, right, in front of the object lens. We should hold the white paper. I think the things are clear to you. Not in front of eyepiece. We should hold the white paper in front of the objective lens. And what we should do is, we should hold the paper in front of the objective and move the eyepiece, right? We should move the eyepiece and we should do the setting until the crosshairs are clearly visible. We should do this thing until the crosshairs are completely visible to us. In front of this particular objective lens, we are going to keep a white paper, right? And we should adjust the eyepiece so that, right, the crosshairs which are present on the telescope, it should be completely visible. We should adjust this eyepiece till the crosshairs are completely visible. So this we call it as an elimination of parallax. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Irshad?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Clear? Any doubts? Okay. The classes are going well? Or is there anything that has to be changed?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, is the thing is going to according to your